Hello, B here, and welcome back to biology. How many organs do you think there are in the human body? Go ahead, take a guess. There are 78 organs in the human body. In order for your body to function properly, all of these organs and body systems have to work together. Think of a baseball team. In order for the team to win, the players must communicate with each other and demonstrate solid teamwork. This is just like the human body. The organs must show teamwork in order for the body to survive and function. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define and identify the main organ systems of the human body. Define and identify the main body cavities. When you think of the word system, you probably imagine a group of items working together to accomplish a task. A computer system is made of a screen, a hard drive, software, a mouse, etc., all working together to bring you this lesson. What about a public transportation system? This would be made of trains and buses that work together to get people from one place to another. The human body is made of 11 organ systems. Each system has a specific and unique job that helps our body remain in homeostasis. However, while their jobs are delineated and have clear functions, there are organs that overlap and work in two different systems. For example, the pancreas secretes gastric juices and enzymes for the digestive system, but also releases hormones for the endocrine system. The organ systems of the human body can be divided into four groups based on their function. The first group's function is to support, move, and protect the body and its organs. This group is made of the skeletal system, or the approximately 206 bones in an adult human, including 26 in each foot alone. The muscular system is made of all of the different muscles in the body. This includes skeletal muscles that you voluntarily control, like the triceps and biceps that move your arm, the smooth muscles that contract involuntarily, like the muscles that line the intestines, and finally, the cardiac muscles that line the heart. The third body system in this group is the integumentary system, which is made of the skin, hair, nails, and glands. The nervous system and endocrine systems are the two main systems that work together to help your body stay balanced, both chemically and physically. The nervous system is like your electrical wiring. It sends messages via electrical impulses between your brain, spinal cord, and the rest of your body. These messages tell your body to move and respond to both internal and external stimuli. The endocrine system is also responsible for sending messages throughout the body, but instead of using electrical impulses, the glands in the endocrine system secrete hormones that keep your body in balance and respond to internal and external stimuli. Most of the organ systems in the body fall under the category of maintenance. These systems work together to keep the body functioning and healthy. It includes the circulatory system, immune system, respiratory system, digestive system, and excretory system. Do you hear that? That sound is the circulatory system. It is made of the heart, blood vessels, and blood, and it works to pump blood from the heart to the lungs, then throughout the body to supply oxygen to all of your organs. The circulatory system works very closely with the respiratory system. The respiratory system's job is to breathe in the oxygen that is then circulated through the body by the blood. This system then expels the carbon dioxide waste that the blood brings back to the lungs. The immune system works as your theoretical boxing gloves. It helps us fight infection from things like bacteria, viruses, fungi, etc. Working with the circulatory system, it produces special cells that then go and fight the pathogens we are exposed to keep us healthy. Ever wonder why you get a spike of energy after you eat a snack? Or why endurance athletes eat pasta the night before an event? It's because they are counting on their digestive system to break down the food into the energy and nutrients we need. Through a series of mechanical and chemical digestive processes, this system breaks down the food and then absorbs the nutrients to nourish our body and provide it with energy. This brings us to our last maintenance system, the excretory system. As we just learned, the digestive system breaks down our food and filters out nutrients. Well, what about the liquid waste? The excretory system's job is to remove waste from the fluids in our body and then expel this liquid waste in the form of urine. The excretory system starts at the kidneys, where it filters waste such as urea and ammonia from the blood, and then sends the liquid waste through the ureters, bladder, and finally through the urethra to exit the body. Now that we have briefly gone over the individual body systems and their roles in the human body, let's spend some time discussing how our body is built to protect these organs. The human body is broken into five main body cavities. These cavities are fluid-filled, which allows them to protect and support the internal organs. The five cavities include the cranial cavity, which contains the brain, the vertebral cavity, which is long and narrow and contains the spinal cord, the thoracic cavity, which makes up the upper part of the trunk and contains the heart and lungs, the abdominal cavity, or the lower part of the trunk, which contains the digestive organs and the kidneys, and finally, the pelvic cavity, which contains the reproductive organs and the bladder. As we went through the lesson today, we started our exploration of the systems that make up the human body. Together, these organs make up a strong, efficient machine that is capable of so many amazing things. Starting in our next lesson, skeletal and muscular systems, we will be doing a deeper dive into each of these body systems. Until next time, remember that biology isn't just science. It's the way of life. Hey, hey.